We're troubleshooting a KitchenAid gas range. The complaint is that none of the burners spark. Gas comes out, but no spark. So we're going to troubleshoot that problem. So we know it's an electrical problem, and the go-to document for that is the schematic. Here's the tech sheet. There's the spark module. This is our load of interest because it's what produces the high voltage spark that's supposed to jump the gap in these electrodes here. And I'll show you here. Here is the electrode and what's supposed to happen when voltage is supplied, really high voltage, it jumps that gap from the electrode up to the top of the burner cap, ignites the gas, and we have flame. So what we want to find out, since the spark module becomes our load of interest, it's the load that's not doing its thing, it's not producing the spark. Couple things. One, are we getting line and neutral as a power supply to the spark module? That's one thing to verify. And then we'll close one of these switches and see if we're actually getting line to the appropriate place, because that will actually energize the spark module to put out the high voltage spark to the electrode. So that's what we're going to check next. So on this range, the spark module is over on the left-hand side, down at the bottom. Just remove the side panel. There it is. I'm not showing disassembly in this video. That's not what I do in my videos. I show troubleshooting. There are other channels on YouTube that show disassembly if you're interested in that. I'm showing techs how to troubleshoot problems and how technology works. Here is the spark module, and you see over here is neutral and line, and that's where we're going to check first. Make sure we're getting a good power supply to the spark module. These lines down here are actually the output. We won't be measuring these because this is very high voltage coming out of the spark module. But we can check and see, make sure the switches are working, and they should be switching. Look in the diagram here. These should be switching line. Each one of these burner switches, that's what these are, switching line. And that tells the spark module which one of these outputs to fire voltage to generate that spark here at the electrodes. Okay, so we're going to check for good line supply, line and neutral on our spark module. And we're coming over here. Let's look over there on our meter. Notice we're on low Z. We have a good power supply going to that spark module. So missing power supply to the spark module is not the problem. Spark module is getting good line input and is still not doing its job. Next step is just to verify that, just pick one or two of these inputs from the burner switches up top. And when one of those is turned on, I should get line voltage at the corresponding terminal down here for that burner. How do I know which one of these corresponds to which burner switch up top? And again, the schematic shows it. So like for the one labeled one, that's the left rear. One labeled two, left front, etc. So we got one, two, three, four. So left rear, according to what the schematic is telling me, left front. That's how we find our way around the spark module. Test. We're going to have one lead here on pin four, which corresponds to the right rear element. Again, they don't show this relationship between pin four and the right rear element on the module itself. You only see this on the schematic. So, but knowing that, then we can get positioned at the right rear switch here. And when my leads are in place, I'm going to turn it to on to cause the, what should be the burner to start sparking. And then I should also see with my lead here on pin four and my other lead on neutral, neutral's my reference for line voltage, then I should be reading line voltage across there with that switch closed. Switch open? No, because the switch is open, right? But when I close that switch, I should be reading line voltage between four and neutral. And that's what we're going to look at now. And I've already got the meter set up here. Again, pin four underneath there. Again, they're not showing the relationship. The schematic shows that. And I've got my other lead on neutral. You see that? So now we're just going to turn that switch on. Switch is on now, and we are getting line voltage. Let's turn that switch off and see the voltage go away. There we go. That's conclusive proof that the spark module is getting good power supply. It's also getting a good start signal from the switch, where the switch is simply sending line voltage to the appropriate terminal to make it start sparking out of the appropriate output port. So we've proven that the spark module is bad, and that's what's going to be replaced now. One other trick I want to share, before you actually change out the module, is use your phone to get a picture. There's lots of wires connected here. If you connect them up in the wrong order, you're going to get weird operation, erratic, constant sparking. You're going to get sparking at a different burner when a switch for another burner is turned on, all kinds of weird stuff. Get a picture, get a couple of pictures, and then refer to that when you're changing the module out. And you'll just remove all the wires from this one, replace the module, single screw there holding it in, put it in, then plug it back in according to your picture.
The module is in, so let's see how we did. The ultimate proof is, does it work? Right rear. All right, looks good. How about that right front? Yes. All right. Left front. Left rear. Problem solved.